think the Tron building's hugely significant to the cultural side of Scotland. I think that historically as a building it has a lot to offer because it has history as a church in Glasgow. It has history in that it was the first jail in Glasgow. It was a private theatre club and then has become a hub for the arts in Glasgow since it was opened to the public. I think it produces a wide variety of types of theatre, and for all age groups. We've got our education programme and our outreach stuff catering for all kinds of communities and trying to engage children in theatre so that we're guaranteeing future audiences, and we're also trying to produce a wide variety of shows with very high production values, with not a lot of money at times because funding's obviously hard, particularly as there's been the credit crunch and everything. But we try and kind of cater for everyone. I think that's it. We try and be as friendly a place as well. I think it's the fact that it's got the bar and the restaurant and the very friendly box office and everything like that. We want it to be a building that people come to, whether they come to see a show or not. It should be part of people's lives. The main house theatre at the Tron seats 230. The main house is used for a variety of shows. We do 6 Tron productions a year, and throughout the year, I'm not sure how many because it obviously varies from season to season, but we do a great number of visiting companies as well in between those times. So we get a lot of visiting companies coming in. We have the National Theatre of Scotland doing shows at the Tron that they tour to us. We have companies like Borderline. We have Random Accomplice do shows here. So there's a huge amount of the theatre community involved within the building, even if they're not here all the time. And of course they bring with them their audiences and their followers, which is good for us and for them. The Changing House was originally built as a rehearsal room at the Tron when there weren't as many plays on as there are at the moment, or as many visiting companies coming to the Tron. And it has since been adapted to become a sort of studio venue within the Tron. So it seats 50, and the seating bank can be arranged in various configurations, although more often than not it's used end on. Assuming you've got your script, you would read that from my point of view and take any notes that you have from it in terms of any information about lighting or sound or props or set elements, where it's set, what period it is. And usually once you've got all that information gathered together, you would meet with your director and designer and check that they want to go with the way that the play describes it, and also see if they've got any particular things that they want to use or not use. So you get an idea. Then the designer will take away that information and they will produce various stages of a set model. So traditionally in theatre you get a kind of concept model, and then a white card model, and then a final full colour model. And then we'll have a rehearsal period, which can be anything from, it's usually about 3 or 4 weeks, where the cast will all be involved and they'll be in rehearsals. I'll have a deputy stage manager usually in rehearsals with them, and they'll take notes of anything that's changing and keep the script updated and make me aware of any props that have been cut or props that have been added, or anything that's not going to work technically based on the information we have from the model and from what the director's planning to do. And we communicate that within our department and try and just facilitate everything and get it all happening as cost effectively and as efficiently as possible. And then you've got a plotting session, so that's sitting with the director and the designer and working out what lighting states they want, so what lights they want on where, what sound they want where. So as the stage manager, that's my time, and what we do is we run the show, and that can last usually about a day for an ordinary play. For something like Panto, it might be a bit longer, 2 days, 2.5 days, because it tends to be more technical. Then you've got time on stage with the cast for dress rehearsals, and then you might have previews, which is the first time we have an audience in. It gives the director and the cast a chance to gauge the audience. So if they're doing something like comedy in particular, that's particularly useful because it helps them kind of work out their comic timing and things like that. And also if it's particularly emotional, and it gives us a chance to speak to audience members or people we know that are in the audience and gauge feedback, see if there's anything that we need to change or improve. And then we'll have the run of the show, which obviously varies from production to production. Panto's one of the few shows whereby you get a wee chance to do a bit of everything. It's flamboyant, you've got cloths, you've got curtains opening and closing. It's very traditional, it's kind of Victorian, a bit music hall. It's seasonal. It gets families doing something together, which I think is really nice. I think it's optimistic. I think it's wholesome. I like that it's a roller coaster as well. I like it that it's a fairy tale. It's just, I think good theatre is essentially all about good storytelling, and what better than fairy tales to do that? And that's what Panto's all about, really. You know, I think it's about heroes and villains and monsters. I think the arts colours people's lives. I think it makes life better. I think it's hugely beneficial to people psychologically. I think it's undervalued in terms of the way it can be used as a teaching aid, the way that it encourages people to talk to each other, the way that it encourages people to listen to one another. You only have to speak to young people doing drama classes and things like that, or drama at school, to see how it can benefit them in coming out the shell or finding a forum in which to express themselves. I also think that the arts, it's just about expressing. It adds colour. It takes a world that's drab and depressing enough as it is, and it just gives it a kind of, it gives it hope. If you've got families, there's things that you can involve them in. If you've got children, there's all sorts of workshops and sort of activities that they can take part in within the Tron. Come and get some food at the bar. Come and join us for a drink. Come and say hello if you're interested. Ask about us. We're more than happy to take time out to tell you about what we do and why we do it and why we love it and why it's important.